Hello everybody, welcome to my video blog from the European Parliament. It's great to have you here. Today we're going to talk about the budget of the European Union. What is it? How is it spent? What are the priorities? What are the things on which it's spent? The big number is 156 billion euros. That's the total expenditure of the European Union. As a comparison, these numbers always are kind of hard to grasp. That's more or less the amount of money that a country like Spain spends in its pensions. How is this money spent? In order to not go over crazy big numbers that we all get confused with, imagine that this is just 100 euros. The Union has 100 euros to spend. How does it spend it? The main policy is rural development and agricultural policy. This area takes 36 euros out of the 100. It's the traditional policy that the European Union has had, agriculture and farming, combined with all the rural development, and it takes a big, more than a third of the budget. Another more than a third of the budget, 34 euros, is taken by the structural funds, which are the funds that are used to fund regions which are a little bit behind, or also to fund competitiveness in other regions. The other third of the budget is spent in smaller programs. Among the most important ones, 7 euros go to Horizon 2020, which is the budget that supports research and development and public-private collaboration businesses in public sector. Your favorite program for many of you, which is Erasmus, costs 2 out of those 100 euros. And then there's 6 euros which are employed for the administration of the Union, the Council, the Commission, the Parliament, all of those institutions take 6 out of the 100 euros, and they employ around 50,000 employees. Is that a lot? Is that little? I don't think it's a lot, contrary to what Eurosceptics say. It's twice the number of public sector employees that the Town Hall of Madrid, for example, has. So it's a budget that is, as you can see from just this description, has been reflecting the historical priorities of the Union. The Union now needs to move forward and look at the future. The citizens want us to use money for digitalization, digital skills, preparing them for the future, employment and for environment. And the Parliament, in its resolution for future budgets of this next year and the years after, has the mandate that the incremental money is allocated, protecting those existing programs, the incremental money is allocated to those priorities. I hope you enjoyed it, and we'll get back in the future. Thank you.